President Rodrigo Duterte taps Cabinet Secretary Carlo Nograles as the new chairman of the Civil Service Commission. He replaces Alicia de la Rosa Bala, who finished her term last February. Prior to his appointment, Nograles served as Cabinet Secretary, as well as the spokesman for Malacañang and for the Interagency Task Force Against COVID-19. With his new assignment, Nograles says all three positions he held will be declared vacant. Nograles will serve as the CSC chair until February 2nd, 2029. Supporters of presidential bet Vice President Lenny Robredo condemn allegations made by Cavite Representative Boying Remulla that some of those who attended a huge campaign rally over the weekend in his home province were paid to do so. Remulla also accused some of the youth attendees of having links to the communist movement. Robredo's allies and supporters are denying this, calling it a case of crowd envy. Remulla, however, is standing by his words despite not having the evidence.
Nakita ko kung may mga napajip na nakaparada na tiga malalayong lugar, mga hindi tiga Cavite. Kaya sinasabi ko nga maraming hakot at meron ding nabayaran na para maten. Maliwanag na merong hakot at merong bayaran at meron talagang leftist organizations na involved.
Former Commission on Elections Commissioner Rowena Guanzon reminds politicians that red tagging is an election offense. Akbayan Party List first nominee Percival Sendanya also calling for an end to the red tagging of the pink movement. He says that Remulla is just making up stories to save face.
Sinasabi ni Representative Remulla is a complete lie. In fact, he is not just putting his own constituents in danger. Iniinsulto niya yung people's movement, yung mga kapwa niya Cavitenyo. So we see how those who are in the administration, those who are in power, are using the anti-terror law as an electoral weapon against the voices of dissent, against the voices in the opposition.
National candidates in the May polls are to be deprived of access to a virtual campaign platform if they skip the debates hosted by the Commission on Elections. The poll body will ban them from using their so-called e-rally channels. COMELEC will instead put a vacant podium in place of the absent candidates. The first COMELEC debates for the presidential and vice presidential bets are set for March 19th and the 20th. The tandem of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Sara Duterte have yet to confirm their participation. This, as the COMELEC believes that the debates are crucial as they help shape the public's opinion.
It's also going to be the last debate immediately prior to the elections. And we feel that the public will be able to finally solidify their decision after hearing the candidates speak. So in a very real sense, it is the turning point.
Senator Bato de la Rosa is set to join the vice presidential bet, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio, on the campaign trail. Now, as for Duterte Carpio's running mate, Bongbong Marcos de la Rosa says he will only support his candidacy if and when President Duterte finally decides to do so.
Pangulong Duterte, very tactically proficient person. Yan, eh. Marami siyang diskarte na minsan na-misconstrued ng iba. Kunyari, pa-dislike siya sa tao, pero yun pala ay susuportahan niya. Minsan naman, meron siya mga kunyari siya susuportahan niya, pero dislike pala niya yun. Lately, meron na naman siya sinasabi na gusto niya Ilocano yung papalit sa kanya sa Malacañang, di ba?